All right, so it looks like Smith & Wesson day at the range. We have the Smith & Wesson 3000, and then we have the 686. The Smith & Wesson shotgun, though, it was a pleasant surprise. This thing's hardly been used, but the funny thing is it's been racked a lot. So I don't know if it was a police version that just never got used, never got shot, or if it's just someone bought it and racked it a lot and didn't take it out to the range. But it's got an 18 inch barrel, which is pretty cool. It's a 4+1 like a Remington 870. Now the 870 mag extensions aren't compatible with it. Actually, nothing 870 is compatible with it except for the stocks. Anyway, I'm going to try to get myself a mag extension for this one and add two more rounds to it. Choate used to make them, and actually used to make them for Smith & Wesson. And some of the Choate ones are actually Mark Smith & Wesson, from my understanding. But I'll try to track one of those down when the funds become available and make this a true riot gun. A couple of other things, it's a 2¾ chamber gun. And let's see, I already mentioned it's an 870, but copy. There's a few differences. How it stops shotgun shells is a little bit different. If you look underneath here, you'll see we have just one smooth piece. There's no need for that cutout in case you get a double feed, because somebody figured out a way to prevent double feeds in this. And you'll find that there's no rails inside of here holding the shot shell back, but it's actually integrated right in with a spring. And anyway, I'll try to tear that apart at some point, maybe in part two, and show you
probably
that.
Probably this one was made in 82. I think they were made between 1980 and 84 in Japan by Hawa.
The fit and finish on this, from the end of the receiver to the end of the barrel, is immaculate, except for some scarring from the previous owners. But the way the butt fits, I mean, it's almost embarrassing to put such a nice shotgun and not fit the stocks to it. But I guess they were trying to put these together very quickly and very cheaply. There was a prior model to this called the Smith & Wesson 912, and it was a flop pretty much. And it really put Smith & Wesson back. And probably one of the reasons that this just never happened, or never was commercially viable. Shotgun's very good. I would class it as smooth as a Wingmaster. Does have the double rails like the 870. They're slightly different dimensions, but man, the thing shoots nicely. You can get these cheap. If you don't mind, if you get them in good working order, you might as well pick one or two up. They're a great gun. Very solid, very reliable. And there's a few places around in the States that'll work on those and have spare parts.
That's so. Smith & Wesson 3000 out. See how it patterns at about, I guess this is about 12 yards, and we've got some double lot buck, some low recoil stuff. So I like think I'm gonna need the mag extension for this.
So that's from here down to here is the outline of a IDPA target. As you can see, the wads have gotten stuck in the target. It is low recoil. It's shooting fairly fast. I think one definitely pulled down here, this one. But at 12 yards, that's pretty much what you want. That being the head area. Let's try five more rounds and see if we can do that
five
faster.
Five more rounds and see if we can get a little speed. That's what happens when you try to go fast. Clear! That has the potential of going much faster. I almost short-stroked it once, so I had to think on my feet. But we'll work on the speed. Let's have a look at the target.
All right, Smith & Wesson 3000. Pretty good shotgun. As you can see, the low recoil buckshot, the wads were getting stuck in the cardboard and the plywood behind it. Although there's a little bit of air coming through now.
And that'd be 10, nope, that's 15 buckshots, so that'd ruin your day.
All right, I'm gonna run back to about 20 yards here and hit this with a slug.
The homemade slug. All right, quick shot with a slug, 20 yards, I'm gonna aim a little bit low.
This is what I was running in the shotgun today, and it's a Dominion 12 gauge 2.75 reduced recoil buckshot. It's a little rougher than the Federal stuff. This is repackaged Russian ammo.
All right, I'm gonna put three more rounds down range. I was shooting cheap Russian ammo, and it was, I'm just trying to see if it runs a little smoother on these Federals. It runs smoother on the Federals. This thing pattern's actually not bad at 30 yards, probably a 4 foot circle.
All right, stay tuned for part two. We'll see if we can do a magazine extension on this thing, and then see if we can make a side saddle. Side saddle, and we'll drill out the holes a little bit. See what we can come up with. Maybe there's somebody out there that makes them, and we can have them undrilled, and we can do our own drilling for it. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you at the range.